Hi book lovers, welcome back to my channel. It is July 23rd, Thursday morning, and Nightfall by Penelope Douglas has just landed on my Kindle. I literally woke up, checked my phone, because that's what I always do, and saw the email that the ARC was sent. I've actually been waiting for this for a couple days because they asked me, I think on Monday, if I wanted to read an early copy, and obviously I said yes, like who would say no? So that's why I'm still in my pajamas, my faded Jonas Brothers t-shirt. The ebook is extremely long. I think Penelope said that it was almost 700 pages for the paperback, but the location, the total location is 11,408, which is crazy long. Usually full-length books are around like 4,000, so this is almost three times that. I'm not sure I'll be truly vlogging me reading this just because I'm not really a big fan of stopping and recording myself. I just want to finish the book, so I think that's what I'll probably do, just finish the book, get my thoughts together, sit down and talk to you guys about everything. As always with my book review videos, the first half is going to be spoiler free, and then I'll let you know when I'll start talking about spoilers. Probably be a timestamp in the description so you can skip that part if you haven't gotten to Nightfall yet. I will be talking about spoilers for the first three books in the Devil's Night series though, but I'll try to warn you when that's gonna happen. If you're new to the series, it is dark erotic romance, four books in total plus a little short novella. I honestly don't know how long this book will take me to read. Hopefully I'll get through it soon so I can post really close to the release date. If you have read the book already or if you've read the series, let me know your thoughts on it, but if you do include spoilers, just put a little warning so people who haven't read it yet can skip your comment. But I really need to get started on this long book, so I'll end this for now and come back when I've finished and have my thoughts together. Hello everyone, I'm back and I have just finished Nightfall. It took me about 24 hours to finish this. I was actually surprised that I read so much so fast. I finished it like early Friday morning. I actually stayed up late about 1:30 Thursday night, and I finished about 80% of the book on that first day. I just could not stop reading Nightfall, but now I'm finished and I'm like trying to get all my thoughts together. There's just so much going on, so much that happened. I actually reread the entire Devil's Night series before Nightfall came. I borrowed all the audiobooks. I actually own Corrupt and I've reread through the audiobook that one like two or three times already, but it was my first time rereading Hideaway and Killswitch. Here are the books in paperback. If you follow Penelope Douglas on Instagram and Twitter, she posted a photo of how big Nightfall is, and it's like double the size of one of these books. It is ginormous, but yes, I reread Corrupt. It was amazing. I loved it. I mean, I love Rika and Michael so much. They are tied as my favorite couple with Damon and Winter. I mean, they're the ones who started it all, and then we finally get their wedding in Nightfall. Book two, Hideaway, is Banks and Kai's book, and honestly, I forgot the most from this book. It was my least favorite. I mean, I still loved it. I give it 4 stars, but definitely I didn't love it as much as Killswitch and Corrupt. There's just a lot going on, but I did love rereading it with the audiobook. Again, I forgot so much of what happened here, so this one was the book that I definitely needed to reread the most. And then book three, of course, Damon's book, the one that most people had been waiting for. I love this one so much. I love Winter. I love Damon. Their love story was amazing, and I thought I remembered more than I did. I did not. So the audio reread was pretty enlightening. There's also the free novella Conclave that you can read on Penelope Douglas's website. It's book like 3.5. Definitely need to read it after you've read these first three books, and a lot of what happens in Conclave comes back into play in Nightfall. But honestly, I would highly recommend rereading the entire series. It was such an amazing experience. I'm so glad I did it, especially because I just forgot so many things that also come back in Nightfall. I remember actually really wanting Will's book to be like second or third. I didn't expect him to be the final book in the series when I read Corrupt, because it was in Corrupt that we found out that he was in love with Emery. He had a thing for her, and then he, you know, burn down her gazebo, her art project. So that whole thing between them, it was there. It had been there since the very first book. So Penelope Douglas definitely made us wait for a very long time to finally get their romance. Everything that happens in the first three books, all these big revelations, these kind of showdowns with their enemies, it all culminates in Nightfall, and it just made my experience reading Nightfall so much better. So again, highly, highly recommend that you freshen up your memory before starting Nightfall, but I mean, obviously you don't have to. So going into this final book, I was pretty much as prepared as I could be, but I truly just didn't expect all of the things that happen. I honestly don't even know what my expectations were, because we never really got any interactions between Will and Emery. We never really met Emery in the first three books, so I couldn't really expect anything between them besides them hating each other. Black Church was a complete mystery, where Will is sent prior to the start of Nightfall. We'd only gotten snippets of it in Killswitch, I believe. So those two things were the ones that I was most excited to read about. If you've read the Devil's Night series, which you probably have if you're gonna read Nightfall, then you're probably familiar with the way that Penelope Douglas structures the books, the romances in the series. Like the first half of each book, it goes back and forth between past and present, and then the second half, it all takes place in the present. So in the first half of Nightfall, the present timeline is Emery having been taken against her will into Black Church, where there are five other men, including Will, and she has to try to survive and escape this place, this prison. The four new men that we're introduced to that are stuck in this prison with Will and Emery are Aiden, Taylor, Rory, and Micah. They're all pretty fascinating characters, but especially Aiden. He plays the biggest role in the story, but we find out that Black Church, I'll keep it as vague as possible, but Black Church is a prison where rich, wealthy parents send their problematic sons to kind of fix their problems. And because they're in a secluded place with no contact with civilization, it kind of becomes a Lord of the Flies situation. These guys become their base selves, they form a hierarchy, and sadly Will is not the alpha, so he can't really protect Emery as much as he would like. But he wouldn't really like to protect her all that much anyway, because at this point he hates her, and for reasons that we'll find out later on in the book. So that's the present timeline, and then we also get flashbacks of Will and Emery, everyone else in high school about 9 years ago. And here we get to see Emery in all her anger and hurt and bitterness. She's a very broken character, and we learn why, but we've learned in previous books that the reason why Will was sent to prison was because he beat up a cop, and that cop was Emery's older brother. And Will beat him up because the brother was abusive to Emery. So trigger warning for anyone who needs one, there's intense domestic abuse, domestic violence. The things that Emery goes through just broke my heart. It's pretty awful to read. And it's because of this abuse that she is such an unhappy person, whereas Will kind of lights up everything and everyone around him. And Emery just didn't want to drag Will down with her, so she pushes him away, even though she knows that he has the biggest crush on her and that he would treat her like everything to him. It is such a volatile relationship between these two in high school. There's so much love, hate, anger, lust. We experience that to the extreme in these flashbacks, and like one moment I would be loving Will and Emery and then hating them the next, being like, why would you do this? Why would you say this? I don't know if I would classify them as like enemies to lovers, because it's not that simple. They're just so complicated, and their romance is probably the hardest, the angstiest out of all four couples. As a whole, I think I feel about Nightfall the same or similar way to how I felt about Hideaway. I'm giving Nightfall 4 stars, which I also gave to Hideaway, mainly because I wanted more romance between them in the present. It's such a long book, and most of it is Will and Emery dealing with their own personal problems, which was pretty much what happened in Hideaway. Like, I wanted more romance in Hideaway, and now I want more romance in Nightfall. I sometimes felt that the spotlight was on everything else but the romance. I mean, not that like everything else wasn't good, it still was, which is why I still really enjoyed this book. But I'm reading this for Will and Emery, and I got so much of them being angry with each other that I just wanted them to be really sweet together. But honestly, that's no longer their dynamic. That's not who they are anymore, especially Will, especially after he got out of prison. He's not the same lighthearted, fun guy that he was. So I totally understand it, but I just can't help wanting them to be a little bit more sweet to each other rather than being so angry. Still, things were always so hot and so explosive between them. Anytime they're together in the same room, they just like butt heads. I did enjoy the way that the romance played out, though most of it does happen towards the very end of the book. But the epilogue was beautiful, so perfect for Will and Emery, as well as all the other couples in the series. And now to talk about these spoilers. There's just so much that happens that I can't talk about without spoiling anything, like Alex and Aiden, the whole orgy scene, the wedding scene, everything with Michael's father, and even the epilogue. There is so much to unpack. I guess I'll start off with Alex and Aiden. I know a lot of readers of the series have been wanting Alex to get her own happily ever after, and she finally does. And obviously it's not with Will. I know a lot of people did want her to be with Will, but no, she has her own guy, and you get a little hint of it in Conclave. So that's one of the main reasons why you should read Conclave before Nightfall. But the guy that did break her heart was Aiden, the alpha at Black Church. I actually did get a little suspicious of this when Aiden was first introduced, and his story, like the reasons why he was sent to Black Church, was revealed when he was talking with Emery, that there was a woman who wrecked him, and I was like, could it be Alex? And it was. I almost wish though that they got their own kind of novella, we got their full story, because we only get really snippets of it, and it's told through Emery and Will's point of views. Aiden definitely needed to grovel more, because he says some awful things to Alex, and I wanted a little bit more than Alex getting a shot for Aiden to suddenly wake up and realize she's the best thing that ever happened to him. But the hospital scene was pretty great, especially when all the guys were so protective of Alex. I also love that with these flashbacks in Emery's point of view, we see that she was also like always in the background, like Will was. She was there when Kai and Banks first met at that confessional. She saw Damon and Winter go out like joyriding on his motorcycle before Winter knew that it was Damon. Like, she knew so many of these horsemen's secrets, and they had no idea. I really love that. And also Damon burying his mother. She was there with him and for him to do that. The dynamic between Damon and Emery was very unexpected, but it makes so much sense because these two were the ones who were, you know, who grew up being abused. They relate to each other on a level that no one else can. And of course, the orgy. I can't not talk about it. Damon himself calls it a weirdo bacchanalian sex fest, and that's pretty accurate. It was basically everyone, including Alex, minus Damon and Winter, mostly because Damon is literally related to two of these people. That would have been very awkward if he was involved in this orgy. But yeah, these people just love their exhibitionism, their voyeurism. Alex and Emery are getting it on, and everyone else is watching them. It was a pretty strange scene, I'm not gonna lie. I mean, I did expect something. Like, there's always that one like intense, insane, sexy scene in each of these Devil's Knights books. Wasn't necessary like some of the other big scenes in the earlier books, like the steam room and Corrupt. Probably not, but I'm not mad about it, honestly. It was really nice to see someone giving something to Alex, because throughout the entire series, people have been taking from Alex and using her, even though sometimes she did, you know, volunteer to help. I do want to clarify that there was no cheating involved in this little sex fest. Michael, Rika, Kai, and Banks were there, but they didn't touch anyone that they weren't engaged or married to. They were literally just watching Alex and Emery. And there was no threesome. Will didn't even get involved. He was just watching. So that was pretty interesting to read. The best thing about it, though, was the fact that Damon accidentally walked in on all of this and literally walked back out. It was so funny when Damon punched all of the guys for involving his two half-sisters in this crazy orgy. Michael and Rika's wedding was so wonderful. I loved it. I loved how the girls welcomed Emery into their fold, how they had a quadruple wedding together. I was honestly expecting just a double wedding, like Michael and Rika and Will and Emery, but nope. The other two couples also renewed their vows. It was a great scene. I really liked it. And also, if you're a Punk 57 fan, which I wish I had time to reread, but I didn't, we do get to see Misha and Ryan, since Misha is Will's cousin, but they mainly show up in the last 20-ish percent when everything is going down with Michael's father. I honestly don't remember that much about these two or their story except for that car wash scene, but it was great seeing them again. Damon and Misha have the funniest relationship. They just nag and hate on each other. And one last thing before I get into the epilogue is the whole Coldfield thing. Coldfield is this underground transportation area thing that Will discovered and has been developing secretly. This is one of the many secrets that he's been hiding from his best friends. Like, we always thought Will just did nothing but drink and do drugs, but nope, he was up to something. He was using his mind for good, and he's the reason why that the four horsemen and the woman are able to take down Michael's father. There's also a little girl who shows up who was living in Coldfield. She kind of comes out of the blue and makes Michael and Rico's life all the better because they knew they weren't able to have kids and ended up adopting her. That part was a little bit cheesy, but I was still really happy for them. And she also comes back into play in the epilogue, which takes place 10 years later. So the little girl is now 18 and is being initiated into their conclave. And right before the epilogue, Penelope Douglas actually writes a little note saying that there's something a little bit open-ended at the end of the epilogue, so you don't have to read it if you want your series, you know, ending nice and tidy. But I would still read the first half of the epilogue. Everyone and their families and their kids, they are so freaking adorable. Damon and his gigantic brood, because of course he would have the most children out of all the horsemen. That scene in the hospital where Winter is giving birth to their second kid was so funny. I really didn't expect Damon to be such comic relief in this book, but he is. But the reason why the end of the epilogue leaves us a little open-ended is because of this mafia family that they're getting involved with. Well, this family has a stake in the horsemen's business. They want a higher percentage, but it also turns out that they want Michael's daughter, his adopted daughter, the girl that showed up in Coldfield. For what? I have no idea. They don't say. And that's how the epilogue ends. And I honestly don't know what to take away from this. Are we gonna get like a second generation of the Devil's Night kids? Is it gonna focus on this mafia family? Are we getting a new series? I have no idea, and I just want all the answers. So it's a very open-ended epilogue, to say the least, but I still loved it. I loved how happy they all are with their families, how powerful they've grown. But yeah, I am so glad that we finally get this finale. It's finally here. I mean, Corrupt came out back in 2015, so it's been 5 years since the beginning of the series. We've been waiting 5 years for Will and Emery. It wasn't perfect for me, but I still loved it. I'm so happy with how everyone ended up. I surprisingly am not feeling all that sad, though, that the series is over because of this open-ended epilogue. Because of that, I'm now expecting to see all these characters again. Maybe not as the main characters, but I'm sure they'll show up, you know, sometime eventually. And then after the epilogue, we also get to see the title of Penelope Douglas's next book, her FF romance. That one is called Trist Six Venom. She's been teasing this FF romance for a very long time. She has teasers on her Facebook group and I've been loving them, so I'm so excited to read this one. I'm pretty sure it's coming out before the Hellbent series, the Fall Away spinoff series, which she says is coming in 2021. And that's about it, I think. I think I covered everything that I wanted to talk about, but if you've read the book, again, let me know your thoughts. If you have any predictions about like a Devil's Night spinoff, let me know. I'm also doing a $50 gift card giveaway on Instagram, thanks to Penelope Douglas. It's a flash giveaway, so it's ending really, really soon, so be sure to enter. If you still need to get Nightfall, I'll link it down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!